Thanks to our seafoil, our boats are the most efficient boats ever made. When flying at 20 knots, the consumption is only 1 kWh per nautical mile, which is roughly like 0.1 liters of gasoline. In 20 knots, you can fall for 2.5 hours or reach 50 nautical miles. So if you want to make an electric boat, the first problem you run into is that batteries are very, very heavy. So you need to reduce the amount of batteries you put into the boat. And a normal planing boat, that one needs a lot of energy. It's like running a sledge on a gravel road. So what we did was to look for other technologies, and then we found the fairly old hydrofoil technology. And by that, you lift the entire boat out of the water. So you free up the hull, it doesn't stay in the water anymore, and you just have these wings underneath the water. The result of putting the boat on hydrofoils is that you reduce the energy needed to push it forward with some 80%. How does a hydrofoil or a wing work? Well, a hydrofoil wing, or any type of wing, is based on the principle of conserving the energy. So if you let a wing run through a fluid, the fluid has to increase its speed just by sort of geometry of the whole thing. And if something increases the speed, it increases energy. And that energy needs then to lower somewhere else to preserve the energy. And in our case, the pressure drops. And in a wing, you try to model the shape of the wing so that you get a pressure drop at the top side of the wing and then a pressure increase at the lower side of the wing. And once you have achieved that, you get really a push upwards, and that's what we use. Once you get the boat up in the air, free from the water, the problem is that it's unstable. You have this wing or the wings underneath the water, and then you have the hull above that. And the center of gravity is above the lifting point, which means that it's unstable. And the way we have cracked that is to use modern types of sensors and a lot of computer programs to fuse all those sensors and push that out to actuators that are actively, constantly changing the angle of attack of the wings in the boat. There are many foil configurations you can use. We have chosen to put the main wing amidship of the boat. That means that the sensors sitting in the front, they report the water surface below them before we actually get to the wing. So we can use the time that is in 10 meters per second, roughly 0.3 seconds, to control the boat in a way that would otherwise not be possible. Once you have designed a good wing, you get something that is super efficient. The wings at Candela, they have roughly a lift to drag ratio of 30. Which means that the force that is hindering the foil to move forward is 1, and then the lift force is 30. That's kind of amazing. Then we need some other stuff like struts and rudder in the water. So the overall lift to drag ratio at the end is roughly 70. Compare that to planing boat, then you have the same ratio, it's 4. So that means a massively longer range on the same amount of energy. It's not only very efficient, it's also much more fun to run. You're basically above the water surface, which means you're also above the waves. That means, of course, less slamming or no slamming at all. And the other thing with this boat is that we can really control how it takes the turns. So it becomes very sporty, very agile, and very responsive to the movements you do in the steering wheel.
Another aspect of that is that you don't get any noise in the boat, because in a normal boat, you get a lot of water against the hull, and that creates a lot of noise that we hear just avoid. So the $100 million question is, why haven't anybody built an electric hydrofoil boat before? I think the reason is, it's damn difficult.